Welcome to another training session on the PLC programming. It is a two-part video tutorial to make temperature controller using the PLC. In first part we will see how does a SSR relay works and how to connect a SSR relay with a PLC. Before going forward I would like to request you guys to please subscribe our both channels for more upcoming video tutorials. What is the use of SSR relay? A solid-state relay SSR is an electrical switch that can be used to turn things on and off using another electrical input. Unlike electromechanical relays, the SSR do not have magnetism and moving contacts. Instead, SSR uses semiconductor switches and optoelectronics. Let's see now how does SSR relay works? As you can see that, the SSR relay have four terminals. Terminals 1 and 2 are the load contacts of the SSR. Load is connected in series with these contacts. When this SSR relay turns on, these load contacts conducts the electric current and supply this current to the bulb. Terminal 3 and 4 are the control terminals of the SSR relay. When we apply 3 to 24 volts DC across these terminals via switch, the load terminal starts to conduct electric current and bulb turns on. And when we turn off the switch, the load terminal stops conducting the electric current and bulb goes off. So this is a simple explanation, how a SSR relay works. Now let's see the setup for today's tutorial. We have a SSR relay, an electric heater, and Wecon PLC. Do visit the Wecon Technologies website. They are manufacturer of most reliable and affordable devices regarding automation industry. Wecon Technologies is the manufacturer and supplier of PLCs, HMI, frequency inverters, and servo motors and servo drives. Wecon Technologies can provide best hardware and software solutions for your next project. Coming back to today's tutorial, we will install this heater in the glass tank, and heat the water by making a timer function in the PLC. First of all, we connect 220 AC supply wires to the PLC. Next, we will connect a phase wire from AC supply breaker to the terminal 1 of the SSR relay, then we will connect a wire from terminal 2 of the SSR relay to one end of the heater. From other end of the heater, we will connect a wire to the neutral strip of the AC supply. Now you can see that, AC power supply, SSR relay, and heater all three things are in series with each other. And SSR contacts are acting as a switch. In order to turn on the heater, we just have to enable the SSR relay. Next let's see how to connect PLC output signal to the SSR relay. This PLC have in build, 24 volts DC power supply. We will connect a small wire loop from 24 volt positive terminal, to the common zero terminal of the PLC. Common 0 is the common terminal of the internal relay of Y0 and Y1 PLC outputs. Whatever voltage we apply at common 0, we will get same at Y0 or Y2 terminals. We will connect a wire from Y0 PLC output terminal to the positive terminal of the SSR and negative terminal of the SSR to the negative terminal of the 24 volts power supply. Now the wiring is completed here. We will see go to the PLC editor software and do some programming. We will insert a rising edge normal open contact M0 on the rung 0. M0 is a start bit. Let's suppose it is coming from the HMI. This M0 bit will hold on a bit M1. We can name this bit a start timer bit. M1 start timer bit will turn on the timer T0 for 15 seconds and in parallels, M1 bit will also turn on the Y0 PLC output. Y0 is output for heater SSR. Once timer is over, we can use its normal close contact in the first rung to turn off the start timer bit M1. We will insert another normal close contact M2 to turn off heater anytime. We can name this bit as stop heater bit. Now programming is complete, we will compile and download this logic into the PLC. As always, I have given the download link for this program in the description. You can download this program and practice this example. As soon as there is a rising edge of start bit M0, the M1 start timer bit gets hold on, and this bit starts the heating timer T0, and in parallel Y0 PLC output turns on, and SSR starts conducting the current. Heater turns on, and water starts to heat up. Now as soon as 15 seconds heating timer is over, its normal close contact opens in the first rung, and turns off the start timer bit M1 and heater turns off. So, now in this first part of the tutorial, we have discussed how to connect a SSR relay with a PLC, and how to connect an electric heater coil with SSR relay. In the second part, we will see how to connect a temperature transmitter with a PLC. How to program an analog input for the temperature transmitter and using this setup, how we can make a program logic to make a temperature controller application in the PLC. That's the end of today's video. Please share, like, and subscribe this channel, and do check out sponsor of this video. Link is in the description box. Till next time, take and goodbye.